This is special COVID-19 coverage on Your Health, a podcast of the Integrated Health and Social Services University Network for West Central Montreal.
And welcome to another edition of the Your Health podcast. This is special COVID-19 coverage. I'm your host, Shaun McMahon. As COVID-19 cases continue to rise across the province, there are more and more questions, and that's what we're here to try to answer, giving you a look at life on the inside of our facilities and the people who make them tick. And that brings us to our latest guest, family physician at Mount Sinai Hospital and Associate Medical Director of Professional Services at CIUSSS West-Central Montreal, Dr. Suzanne Levitz. Thanks for joining us.
Oh, thank you.
All right. So right off the top, I'd love to chat a little bit about your role as a physician in long-term care right now amidst this COVID-19 pandemic and what it all means for you and for your patients. And maybe tell us what the overall mood is like on the inside.
So Mount Sinai, as you probably know, is a kind of unique institution because we're a combination of a long-term care, palliative care, and short-term rehab pulmonary care hospital. So we have our own challenges, a little different from regular long-term or regular rehab hospitals. It's a challenging environment, but one that's working very well in the time of shutdowns and new guidelines coming from everywhere.
All right. Now, the last few days, everybody's talking about visitor restrictions, and we know that it's a necessary step to protect the most vulnerable members of our community, but family members on the outside, understandably concerned about life for their loved ones on the inside. What can you tell us, Dr. Levitz, about the care that they're receiving and your take on why it's so important to be restricting access right now?
Well, I'll start with why it's so important to restrict access. We know that spread now has been determined to come from the community as well as from travelers. We were a step ahead here in restricting all the access before we noticed that this spread was happening. This has probably protected our population from potential outbreak down the road. We know that once the COVID-19 gets into our elderly and sick patient population, that it could spread like wildfire throughout the institution. So we've been very lucky that we've had no cases among our patients. And because there are no visitors coming in and out, we have decreased the risk of all of our patients and our staff getting this virus.
And now, just because this is the guideline at the moment, it doesn't mean that there aren't some exceptions. Can you tell us a little bit more about the exceptions that are being made for patients who are palliative and end of life?
Absolutely. So, of course, we want family to be able to be near their loved ones in their times of need. We do have a palliative care unit, and understandably, a lot of these people are at the end of their life. So we are making sure that family members can come and visit with their very sick loved ones on the palliative care unit. We are controlling the access in that only 1 to 2 people can visit at a time, and they're restricted to visiting only the family member. So even though there are some visitors coming in, we are controlling the access so that there is no crowding. We're limiting their exposure to the staff, but they can be beside their loved one as they approach the end of their days. We are making the same kind of allowances in long-term care for patients who are becoming ill or near the end of their time with us, that their family members can come and be with them near the end. But this is on a very, very restricted basis, again, limiting the exposure of other patients and our staff.
We're in conversation with Dr. Suzanne Levitz from Mount Sinai Hospital. Last one for you. I'm just curious how you're doing, what your personal take is on this whole situation, how you've been living it all.
Well, it's been a challenge, but I have to say I've been very impressed with how all our teams have come together at an administration level, at a clinical level, how we've all been able to work together, how we've all supported each other. There have been stressful moments in all of this when guidelines change very quickly, yet everyone has adapted and come together to make this work. I've been especially impressed by our staff who's been able to step up to the new challenges of filling in for families who were doing things for a lot of our long-term care patients before. We have increased our staffing in our long-term care ward to make sure that all our patients are being fed and clothed and dressed and compensating for the care that the families were so involved with before. So I'm just so impressed with our team. It has made me feel more confident in how we are able to manage this and how we will be able to continue to manage what comes comes our way in the coming weeks.
Well, I think I speak for everybody listening, saying that that's awfully comforting to hear. That's very, very nice to hear, you know, knowing that there's that level of support. And it seems like everybody's really rowing in the same direction just for the greater good at this point, because there's still a lot of work to be done. But it seems like everybody is on the same page. And that's awfully nice to hear. So I really appreciate you taking the time. Dr. Suzanne Levitz, a family physician at Mount Sinai, the Associate Medical Director of Professional Services for CIUSSS Centre-Ouest. Thanks for everything that you've been doing, and best of luck going forward. Thanks for joining us on the Your Health Podcast.
Thank you.
You've been listening to special COVID-19 coverage on Your Health, a podcast of the Integrated Health and Social Services University Network for West Central Montreal. Don't forget to subscribe at ciusswestcentral.ca/podcast or on your favorite podcast platform.